That's just a blank sheet.
What?
The bidding, Chris.
Well, that's okay then. Maybe you make up your own then.
Alright. Just invent.
Thank you. The 5 minute bell has sounded. Please maintain a respectful silence so that people can prayerfully prepare for Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with
you. In the first Sunday of Lent, we always go into the desert with Jesus. And the reason Jesus had the courage to go into the desert was because he heard his Father call him the Beloved. When we know we are loved through and through, then we are secure. We can face the beasts in the desert, in the wilderness, in the depth of our own hearts. And so we pause. We give thanks to a God that loves us and sustains us through the trials of life. And we ask forgiveness for those times when we failed to be the caring, considerate individuals you're asked to be. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, who pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Kyrie eleison. Christ eleison. Kyrie eleison. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, through the yearly observances of Holy Lent, that we may grow in understanding of the riches hidden in Christ, and by worthy conduct pursue their effect. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Move the children forward, please, for the children's liturgy.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God spoke to Noah and his sons, "See, I establish my covenant with you and with your descendants after you, also with every living creature to be found with you, birds, cattle, and every wild beast with you, everything that came out of the ark, everything that lives on the earth. I establish my covenant with you. No thing of flesh shall be swept away again by the waters of the flood. There shall be no flood to destroy the earth again." God said, "Here is a sign of the covenant I make between myself and you and every living creature with you for all generations. I set my bow in the clouds, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I gather the clouds over the earth, and the bow appears in the clouds, I will recall the covenant between myself and you and every living creature of every kind. And so the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all things of flesh." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
faithfulness and love for those who keep your covenant. Lord, make me know your ways. Lord, teach me your paths. Make me walk in your truth and teach me, for you are God my Saviour. Your ways, Lord, are faithfulness and love for those who keep your covenant. Remember your mercy, Lord, and the love you have shown from of old. In your love remember me, because of your goodness, O Lord. Your ways, Lord, are faithfulness and love for those who keep your covenant. The Lord is good and upright. He shows a path to those who stray. He guides the humble in the right path. He teaches his way to the poor. Your ways, Lord, are faithfulness and love for those who keep your covenant.
The second reading is from the first letter of St. Peter. Christ himself, innocent though he was, died once for sins, died for the guilty, to lead us to God. In the body, he was put to death. In the spirit, he was raised to life. And in the spirit, he went to preach to the spirits in prison. Now, it was long ago, when Noah was still building that ark, which saved only a small group of 8 people by water, and when God was still waiting patiently that these spirits refused to believe. That water is a type of the baptism which saves you now, and which is not the washing off of physical dirt, but a pledge made to God from a good conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has entered heaven and is at God's right hand, now that he has made the angels of the dominations and powers his subjects. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The Spirit drove Jesus out into the wilderness, and he remained there for 40 days and was tempted by Satan. He was with the wild beasts, and the angels looked after him. After John had been arrested, Jesus went into Galilee. There he proclaimed the good news from God. The time has come, he said, and the kingdom of God is close at hand. Repent and believe the good news. The Gospel of the Lord. When was the last time that you were driven by the Holy Spirit? When was the last time the Holy Spirit was in the driving seat in your life? When was the last time you allowed the Holy Spirit to drive you into the wilderness following in the footsteps of Jesus? Jesus is driven out into the desert by the Holy Spirit directly after he hears the Father call him my beloved. In baptism, we too are called God's beloved children, whether we hear the voice or not. And that belovedness, knowing that we are loved by God, gives us the courage to step out into the unknown, into the wilderness. Tomorrow, which is now today, the remains of Margaret Gethins will be received into St. Andrew's Cathedral. Margaret would have been 100 in September, so she's seen a lot of life, a lot of changes in the last 100 years, made a lot of friends and family in the process. 70 odd years ago, she was friendly with the Gallagher family from Clement Park, and Margaret's husband, Pat, was very friendly with Bernard Gallagher. And Margaret used to recall that they would go together for retreats to the Redemptorist Monastery in Cunhull. It's always been part of our Catholic tradition to take time aside, especially during Lent, and go into the wilderness with the Lord. On Friday, I was able to take time out and to go into the desert with the Lord. Or if not the desert, a remote place with sand dunes and wild beasts, commonly referred to Tensmuir Forest. And it's the first time in a while that I've dedicated considerable time simply to being with God. I was hoping for a quiet, relaxing walk. However, due to the mid-term holiday, the car park was going like a fair, and the beach was more like Blackpool than the Fife Coast. However, walking further up the beach provided the solitude and wilderness that I was looking for. And it wasn't long before I was looking for a distraction, longing to check my phone, take a phone call, read a book, answer a text, anything. But I resisted, on the whole, and simply continued walking and looking and appreciating. At one point, it was even that warm that I was able to lie down in the dunes and simply enjoy the heat on my body. But it was difficult. Simply being might be equated to being bored, doing nothing. And of course, the restlessness that exists in the heart of each one of us is hard to pacify. We long to be up and at it, ignore it, go on with something else, rather than wrestling with restlessness itself. As the day wore on, and the light began to fade, I retreated to the car and Kindle, reading about the Carmelite sister Ruth Burroughs. Sister Ruth died last November at the ripe old age of 100, and it can be reasonably said that she was one of the most spiritually attuned people of the last 100 years. She's written numerous books and was the best friend of Sister Wendy Beckett, the art historian. Sister Burroughs is most famous for her honesty about the human condition and her own experience of the human condition in particular. As a child, she was very sensitive and prone to loneliness and fear. We would perhaps now refer to it as existential angst. To such an extent that in her early teenage years, she doubted the existence of God. However, a conversion experience at the age of 17 saw her turn her back in Oxford University and enter a Carmelite convent. However, she continued to sense and feel nothing of God. And eventually, she came to the conclusion that she would accept that situation, accept the emptiness, the loneliness, the suffering. And she found little comfort in the spiritual books in the library in the convent. They described various stages of spiritual growth that she couldn't associate with, hadn't felt. In her emptiness, she considered all this as bunk. However, she did persevere, held fast by the conversion she had had as a 17-year-old, and eventually she came to the realization that her empty-handedness was her way to God, and that in doing so, she was participating in the great act of Jesus, where he emptied himself to become one of us, even to death on a cross. She slowly became aware that the inner angst that she suffered, the fear and loneliness, were a participation in Jesus' own feeling of abandonment, and that the only way to survive it was to place her absolute trust in God the Father. So her acceptance led to trust, a trust that she described as absolute surrender to God. That's what can happen when we wander into the wilderness. When you become bored, I would recommend it. It's a challenge. Persevere in simply being there. You'll have to face your own wild beasts, your own emptiness and fears. However, in persevering, in accepting, and eventually trusting, we can quite literally join in the great prayer of abandonment that Jesus offered from the cross. Father, into your hands I commit my spirit. Let us stand and profess together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Now we pray for the church, the world, and those in need.
For the church, we pray that the Holy Spirit may lead all of us in the church to a deeper conversion, so we can clearly hear the cry of the earth and the cry of the poor. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For world leaders, we pray for world leaders that they may make wise decisions for the good of all the members of our global family. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our global family, we pray for the poorest communities in our global family, especially those in Rwanda who are in need. May our actions this Lent be signs of hope for all. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For Catholic education, we ask that you bless the educational endeavours of all our young people here in Scotland and young people in Rwanda. May they both have access to quality education that equips them for a life filled with promise and purpose. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For women and girls, loving God, we pray for the safety and protection of women and girls in Rwanda. Shield them from harm, violence, and exploitation, and grant them a peaceful and secure future. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For global justice and peace, we pray that the Spirit of peace will give us the strength to build a just world together. Inspire leaders and decision makers to advocate for a society where everyone is treated with dignity and respect. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For hope and faith, Heavenly Guide, grant women and girls of Rwanda the gift of hope and faith. May they find solace and strength in their relationship with you, knowing that you are always with them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We remember in our prayers those who have died recently. Jacqueline MacDonald, Rose Brown, Barbara Davy, John Long, Joseph Callahan, Margaret Gethins, Mary Agnes Malone, Harry Bolan, and Joe Carroll. And for those whose anniversaries occur at this time, Jimmy Carroll, Mary Tinney, Alice Kelly, Martin Bogue, Catherine Folan, Ellen Keenan Squire, Louise Hayes, George Stephen, Anna and Alex Small, and Angela Fortuna. May they rest in peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. We pause for a moment now and we offer those intentions in our own hearts. And we offer them with Mary our Mother as we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And we make all of these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Give us the right dispositions, O Lord, we pray, to make these offerings, for with them we celebrate the beginning of this venerable and sacred time. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, by abstaining 40 long days from earthly food, he consecrated through his fast the pattern of our Lenten observance, and by overturning all the snares of the ancient serpent, taught us to cast out the leaven of malice, so that celebrating worthily the Paschal mystery, we might pass over at last to the eternal Paschal feast. And so, with the company of the angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis in cieli et terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini. Hosanna in excelsis. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Martin our Bishop-elect, the clergy, and all the faithful. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we have the confidence to pray. Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Miserere nobis, Agnus Dei, et tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis, Agnus Dei, et tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Renewed now with heavenly bread, by which faith is nourished, hope increased, and charity strengthened, we pray, O Lord, that we may learn to hunger for Christ, the true and living bread, and strive to live by every word which proceeds from your mouth, through Christ our Lord. If you'd be seated for a couple of minutes, please, and can we have those people who are presenting their children for baptism to come to the front, please? Those people who are presenting their children for baptism. Everyone can see you, Andrew, please. Yeah. Dear parents, congratulations on the safe arrival of your baby, or indeed for the continued development of your child into God's beautiful world. Your child is at the threshold of life's journey, and we wish you the very best. Our Catholic community here at the Parish of the Immaculate Conception, St. Mary's in Lochee, is very aware of the many joys and challenges facing parents in today's world, and wishes to offer you our support and encouragement. Your desire for baptism for your child is part of the journey you make with them in the great unfolding of God's plan for their and your lives. At baptism, your child is enveloped in God's love. They are brought to Jesus Christ in a very intimate way and become a member of Christ's family, the Church. By seeking baptism for your child, you promise to teach them to avoid evil and to love God and neighbour. You promise to raise your child in the Catholic faith and the way of life. You also pray for the grace to be good parents, because, as the baptism ceremony says, you are the first teachers of your child in the way of faith. And so, let us pray. Lord God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for your great goodness in calling us to know you and to put our trust in you. Fill these parents, godparents, and guardians with your Holy Spirit. Increase their knowledge and love of you and strengthen their faith. Give your Holy Spirit to these children, that they may be born again and made heirs of everlasting life. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Parishioners of St. Mary's Lochee, these will be your newest members. Please support them and pray for them and encourage them. And just now we can do that by giving them a round of applause. I would like to invite Jen forward, please, just for 1 minute.
Hi, I'm Jen, and I've been asked to speak a little bit about my experience of Alpha, that just ran from over the last autumn. Last September, my grandson's head teacher told us about the baptism preparation course taking place here at the church after Mass. We don't come from a Catholic family or for a family who attend any church except for weddings, but my grandson wanted to be baptised, so along we came. At the beginning of Mass, Father Jim invited all the children to go to the children's liturgy. Very nice lady sitting behind us confirmed that my grandson could also join the children. And after Mass, I turned to thank the lady, and she invited us to join the Alpha course meeting in the church hall at noon. We were curious, so went to the church hall to find out more, and immediately were made to feel welcome by everyone in the group. As I knew very little about the Catholic Church, I wasn't sure I would have anything to offer the group, and I didn't have any expectations at first that I would want to join the church myself. But as I was keen to find out more, and at the end of the day's discussion, I agreed to come back again. The course ran after Mass on Sunday for 10 weeks, and there was also a retreat day away. Each week, the course started with a short video talk introducing the Christian faith and the uniqueness of faith journeys. Then there was a group discussion on the content of the video. The course was run as a respectful, safe place for everyone to ask questions and share faith journey experiences if they felt comfortable doing so, but there was no pressure for anyone to share if they preferred not to. Many of the group described themselves as cradle Catholics, meaning they were born and baptised into Catholic families. Some had grown up with a strong connection to the church, some had left the church and then returned, and some of the group had converted to Catholicism in adulthood. All of the group had their own faith journey and were progressing through this at their own pace. Every week I got to know the people in the group better, and I found I was starting to get to know myself a bit better too. I found the video talks and group discussions very helpful. The topics encouraged me to think about and explore my own understanding of faith and to begin my own faith journey. Knowing that even the cradle Catholics had questions gave me some comfort, because I had a lot of questions, and I still do. But now I know that I can ask. For me, Alpha was a gentle, welcoming and supportive introduction to the church, a great way to get to know other people and to explore my own feelings about Christianity. If, like me, you're curious or want to deepen your own relationship with God, Alpha's a great way to begin. Thank you.
So the next Alpha course will be starting after Easter, and I would encourage everyone to join it. But just now, we've got a course that runs through Lent to help you prepare for the great celebration of Easter. And the first week starts in the hall, the upper hall, right after Mass. So please, if you can, come along. Very straightforward. It will only take an hour. And as Jen says, these things help you to deepen your faith. Please make the little sacrifice of an hour. The Lord be with you.
And
the Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.